Hi, I'm Jonathan, a full-stack web developer and instructor here at Treehouse. In this course, we're going to build a REST API with Laravel, one of the most popular PHP frameworks today. Even if you've never built an API, the concept is very similar to web applications. They both take in a request and return a response. The critical difference is how they respond. Web applications return an HTML format, while REST APIs most commonly return a JSON format, and sometimes XML. So what is REST exactly? REST is an acronym that stands for Representational State Transfer, an architectural style first represented by Roy Fielding in 2000. Check the teacher's notes below to learn more about Roy Fielding and the six guiding constraints for all REST APIs. The most important constraint to remember is statelessness. Requests from clients to the server must contain all of the information necessary to understand the request and cannot store any state context on the server, only on the client. It's also important to remember that application state is not the same as resource state. Resource state, in the context of REST, is the state of some data represented on the server at any point in time. Application state, on the other hand, is everything necessary to keep your application running, which is stored in the server's memory and is faster than storing and retrieving information from a database. For example, to identify incoming requests, such as creating, modifying, or deleting a resource. Before taking this course, you should be familiar with setting up a Laravel project with Composer and have a basic understanding of REST APIs using Postman. If you need to brush up on Laravel, Composer, REST APIs, or Postman, check out the teacher's notes below. As always, you can use the controls to speed up or slow down this video, and the captions are movable, so feel free to move the closed captions to suit your needs. Finally, try to develop a solid habit of reading the Laravel documentation regularly, and be sure to select the correct Laravel version as well. Laravel has excellent documentation, and if you're not sure what version of Laravel you're working with, navigate to your project directory in the terminal and type PHP artisan --version to find out. Building a REST API is a valuable skill that any PHP developer should have in their wheelhouse of development skills. Front-end frameworks are becoming more popular every day, and they will all need a back-end server responding to their requests. Mobile applications have become part of everyday life around the world, and yet they all need to communicate with a database or some infrastructure, most commonly REST. In this course, we'll build a REST API with Laravel that allows you to submit your favorite books and authors. The REST API we're building from scratch can return a list of books with authors and also allows you to submit, update, and delete books and authors. This aggregating of information is a common use case for APIs as well as SaaS applications, short for Software as a Service, such as TurboTax or Spotify. Let's get started. To get started, you'll need to install Laravel with Composer, then create a new Laravel project in your preferred working directory. For demonstration purposes, I'll use Laravel _apps in the desktop directory, like this. Open the terminal and navigate to the desktop using the cd desktop/Laravel_apps command. Then use the following command to create a Laravel project using Composer, like this. While Composer installs Laravel, it's worth noting that any existing Laravel project that uses dependencies will need to run the Composer update command to install any dependencies used by the existing application. Since this is a new project, We don't need to use the Composer Update command, but you will eventually need to use it when working with Teams or when you want to run an existing Laravel application using dependencies. To learn more about Composer Update and Laravel Mix, check out the teacher's notes below. Next, let's navigate to our new Laravel project using cd Laravel underscore REST underscore API, then use the following command to open our new Laravel project in Visual Studio Code. Finally, let's view our Laravel app by using the following command in the integrated terminal, like this. Great job! We have our Laravel application up and running. Before we continue, let's open a new terminal so we can continue serving our Laravel application using the first terminal. Next, create a database, user, and password, which we'll add to the .env file like this. Note that some Mac OS users may need to use an additional database variable named db underscore socket. Remember, if you need to review how to create a database, user, and password, or you're getting errors such as db errors or max length errors, be sure to check the teacher's notes below. To test our new Laravel application and the database credentials we entered, simply type php artisan migrate in the terminal. Great job! We successfully migrated our database. This next step is optional, but I like to use the default welcome view for testing so I can see what our API looks like in the browser as we add new routes. Let's edit the welcome view located in the resources/views directory, or download the project files and simply paste the welcome blade like this. First, change the titles on lines 7 and 84 to build a Laravel REST API. Next, let's add the following links. Replace the pound sign with the URL for your README if you have one for this project on GitHub. Next, we're going to add the authors link. The authors link uses the built-in env function to access the app URL. Cool, huh? Next, we're going to add the books link like this. The books link also uses the built-in env function to access the app URL. Finally, let's add a Chrome extension link like this. The handy Chrome extension named JSON Formatter displays JSON in a more human-readable format. Let's take a look at the updated welcome view. Nice job! We have a landing page, or welcome view, showing off our application with a README, our author, and book routes, and a link to the JSON Formatter Chrome extension. We're off to a great start. We've installed Laravel using Composer, added our database credentials to the env file, and tested our database connection using the artisan command php artisan migrate. We even updated the welcome view to make a useful landing page. In the next section, we're going to delete our default migrations and use artisan to create our project's database models and migrations. See you there.